Day 7 of the first week of the trading course, or the last day on this trading course, week 1, we're now going to talk about how to build your own strategy or model. And I have given you what I think is the most important ICT concepts, and what I think, in my opinion, is the most easy ICT concepts to understand. And of course, there are other ICT concepts, but I just prefer to use these ICT concepts I've taught you in this trading course. And if you have not watched the other videos within this training course, don't just jump all the way over here and think that you can find a easy 100% win rate strategy. It doesn't work like that. So watch the full training course if you haven't watched that. Now, when it comes to building your own strategy, it can be easy and very complicated at the same time. Because when you're building your own strategy, it all comes down to both screen time and also comes down to both personal preference. And you can't just, in my opinion, copy a other trader's strategy and get 100% win rate with it just because he has 100% win rate, just an example, because he can have, or that person can have it way more easy to spot his own strategy within the market compared to you. He has maybe like 2 or 3 years of screen time trading this strategy compared to you that have maybe 1 week trading that strategy. So then using or finding your own strategy within the market is very important, in my opinion, because copying other traders' strategy, it doesn't really work most of the time. And the way you can build your own strategy, that's what we're now going to talk about. There's one approach which I really like to use when it comes to building your own strategy or model. And that is basically finding one ICT concept which you are great at spotting within the market, or that you just think is very simple and you can repeatedly find it within the market. And then when you have found that one ICT concept which you are great at spotting, then you want to build your strategy around that ICT concept. And basically, let's say that you want to, or that one ICT concept is a fair value gap, then you want to build your strategy around that fair value gap. An example of this could be right here. We can see price swept sell side liquidity. And then a strategy building around a fair value gap would be when price sweeps the sell side liquidity, then we want to find a fair value gap right after that sweep on liquidity and take that fair value gap. So right here, price swept sell side liquidity, we have this fair value gap, which is the first fair value gap that forms after the sweep on liquidity. Then we can take that fair value gap because we are great at spotting it within the market, as that's why we chose this ICT concept, right? So then price makes the sweep, first fair value gap, take that fair value gap, and boom. That could be an example on how you can build your own strategy around a ICT concept, which you are great at finding or spotting within the market, or just in general using. And now you may ask, how do I know which ICT concept that I'm great at spotting or using within the live markets? Well, that's by through screen time, and I've talked a lot about this on my channel recently. And it's just because screen time, it is a very, very important factor, because if you just watch one YouTube video about a person's strategy, that doesn't really mean you can trade that strategy live market. So you really, you know, have to build up that screen time experience, finding out what ICT concept you're great at using, and then start building a strategy around that one ICT concept. Sometimes there's also ICT concepts, which is almost a model within itself, and that could be a change in state of delivery. And basically, as we talked about in my ICT order block video, a change in state of delivery is price sweeping sell side liquidity, and the candles, or consecutive down close candles, or candles going down to that sweep on liquidity that we could consider as our change in state of delivery. An example of this would be right here, price swept that sell side liquidity all the way down here, right? We can see that. We can also see that we have 2 down close candles going into that sweep on liquidity. Price made a close above the opening price of the highest candle on that change in state of delivery. Now we can use that change in state of delivery as a trade entry. So that's basically some ICT concepts is more almost going to be a model within themselves. But when we have ICT concepts like a change in state of delivery, that's where you can implement a little twist to it. And basically we can see that we have a inversion fair value gap and also a fair value gap within here. So that's basically something that we can use within our change in state of delivery. So we have 2 areas or 3 areas where price is going to support pushing price higher. as we have our change since day of delivery, we have a confirmation that price just swept the sell side liquidity, and that we also have a fair value gap and an inversion fair value gap. So that is also something that we have to notice, that we compare other ICT concepts with each other, or just, as I talked about before, building a strategy around one ICT concept which we are great at spotting or using. There's one very important thing that we have to keep in mind when trying to build our own ICT strategy. That is not overcomplicating things. As when we are beginners, we usually tend to put everything together that we have learned and then make one simple ICT strategy around that. And first of all, that is not going to work that well, as when we are, or when we have to maybe have 10 or 12 confirmations before taking a trade entry, we usually end up not taking a trade entry. And when you are forcibly taking a trade entry, not having all your rules together, then it's going to be tough mentally. So basically what I'm trying to say is we have to not overcomplicate things and not overwhelm ourselves with all the ICT concepts and put them together. As I said earlier, just keep it simple and plain. Find one ICT concept that you are great at using, and then build a strategy around that one ICT concept instead of taking maybe 10, 12 ICT concepts or confirmations before finding one trend entry or one strategy. I think ICT also talked about it on his channel, actually, where he said that you should have a simple strategy that you can write down on the back of a business card. And I think he's totally right about that. Personally, I like to have around 2 to 7 rules, or 2 to 9 rules around there. As 2 rules, then you can have your change in state of delivery, and 9 rules, I think that is a bit much. But if you are great at just in general using many rules, or just you want to have more confirmation, then 9 rules is perfect for you. Go with that. Of course, you could have more or less depending on what trader you are, but I just prefer to stay in that range. When we have found out our trading strategy or built our own ICT model, there's a couple of ways we can practice that model. And the first way being back testing, and the second way being watching the live markets. And first of all, I'm going to talk about watching the live markets. The way we can practice our own strategy watching the live markets is that we can either take the trade entry within our head. So basically, let's say that price have played out this fair value gap right here. And then we see that price, or this follows all our trading rules, and we see price makes a return in here. Then we can use our long position tool in on trading view, enter there, put our stop loss at this low, and then target maybe this high. And then we can visualize or journal this trade, and I have made a video about journaling within our head, or maybe write it down, and then we can just get experience or learning how our strategy works through doing that. I prefer to use watching the live markets over than backtesting, because when we are trading, we're watching the live markets. We're not just seeing candlesticks moving every second. So watching live markets is definitely the way for me. The second way we can practice our trading strategy is through backtesting. And backtesting is basically something that we can pay for in on TradingView, where we can pay for bar replay, and I think it costs $11 a month or something like that. And then you can press here on TradingView on select bar, or just bar replay, press on the area where you want to cut price, and then you can just go through there. And then the way we can backtest is that we can say, let's say we want to take this change in state of delivery trade entry, which we just talked about before. Then we can insert right here, press stop loss beneath this low, and then target higher prices. So let's see what happens. We can see right here, price goes down there into the fair value gap also. Then we're going to put our stop loss beneath the low and then target higher prices. And then you can just play price through and see what happens. And we can indeed see price took out or take profit. So that's also another way that we can test our trading strategy through backtesting.